Hello, everybody. This is Scott Bradley from www.scottbradley.name. And in this video, I'm going to share with you a system that I feel is really effective in saving emails that you get from people, but you don't necessarily want to delete them from your inbox, but you still want to have access to them in the future. If you're anything like me, I love having a clean inbox, an uncluttered space that allows me to allow the new information to come into my inbox and allow me to process it. And I found that by sending a lot of the email that I want to save but not completely delete, this little system is going to be really helpful for you. So it's really a simple system to set up. This is going to be a pretty quick video for you. The best way to do it is, as you know, in the previous videos I showed you how to find your Evernote email. And if you aren't aware of that, let me just show you real quick. You're going to come up here and click the little arrow, and you're going to go to account settings. And down here is your email notes too. So for instance, say that you get emails from people, they've been sitting in your inbox for a while, and you don't want to delete them, but you still want to have access to them in the future. This little system is really going to be that helpful thing for you, that you can forward these emails to that email address. They're all going to be popped into your inbox, which is your incoming notebook, and then you'll be able to categorize them given the way that I'm going to show you in this video. So let's just get started. The first thing you need to do is to create a new notebook, and I like to call this notebook Emails. Save. So let's just say, for all intents and purposes, this is the email that I got that I forwarded into my Evernote from my own email account, and I wanted to save it. So what I would do is I'd click my inbox, would be step one, and then I would click it, drag it, and drop it into the emails note. And just for all intents and purposes, I'm just going to do like example here. I'm not going to forward because, as you saw in previous videos, I'm having problems emailing into my Evernote. So anyway, let's say this is an example email, and we're just going to put, you know, email text here. Done. So say that you want to save this email. What I would do is I'd click this, I'd drag this to emails, and I'd drop it there. And then what I would do is, now that you have this email here, you can imagine you're going to get emails from all these different types of people, all different types of contexts, all individual, depending on what you're doing and how you're doing it and what you're trying to save. This tagging structure that I'm going to give you is going to be also very powerful. So to edit and make sure that you can find it in the future if you need to access it, you're going to go up here and you're going to click the little pencil. And I would do a tagging structure where I would go, okay, in this notebook here, I'm going to have emails from all these different people that I want to save. But in order for me to keep everything straight and find things more effectively, I am going to do this tagging structure. So I would start with EM for email, and if you saw my previous videos for brain dump or contacts, you'll understand why I'm doing that. And then I would also put the name of the person that the email is from, or the company that the email is from that you wanted to save. So for instance, let's say this is from John Smith, and then press enter, and then you're going to be done. Now the reason this is valuable is because in the future, as you start getting email and email and email, and you start forwarding into your inbox, you'll be able to take time at the end of the day to go click, drag, email, tag it, who it's from. Click, drag, email, you know, come back to the inbox, click, drag, email, tag who it's from, or what company it's from that you want to save. And as you can imagine, you're going to build up all of these tags over here with email John Smith, email company name one, email company name two, email company name three. And these are the emails that it's the valuable stuff that you want, but you don't want to delete it completely. You may want to delete it out of your inbox, but you still want to save it for future reference. So as you can imagine, you're going to get all these tags with email John Smith, email this, email that. And let's say you find this instance where you go, oh, I need to reference that email that I was sent a couple months ago by John. Let me go into my Evernote because I know it's there. All your keystrokes are going to be is, and assuming there's going to be thousands of emails in here and multiple different tags, you'll all be able to just go tag emails, and I want to see the ones from John, boom, and they're going to be in the reverse chronological order. So the most recent one that you tagged with John is going to be at the top, and the older ones are going to be towards the bottom. So the reason, again, this is valuable and this tagging structure is valuable for you is because it allows you to, A, categorize what emails you got from, who what person, and even more so, it makes you it's easier to find them going forward in the future. So that is the video for today, and I really hope that you found this to be valuable. I know it was pretty short, sweet, and to the point, but that's how I like to do things, so I really hope that you like that. Thank you again so much for your attention. I really hope that you're enjoying these videos, and I am wanting to let you know I'm always up for reading your feedback. I read every comment. I reply to every comment. So if you do feel you like this, you don't like this, tell me what your thoughts are. Always open to hearing your feedback. So I really hope you have a great rest of the day and a wonderful rest of the week.